Hi, and welcome to the presentation on the STEM OPT extension. In this video, we will go over what the STEM OPT extension is and basic eligibility requirements. The STEM OPT extension is a continuation of your OPT work authorization. This is available to students with a STEM eligible degree. This extension allows an additional 24 months of work authorization. You may be authorized once per higher degree level and no more than twice in a lifetime. In order to be eligible for the two-year STEM OPT extension, you must meet some basic requirements. First, you must be in a valid period of post-completion OPT, and USCIS must receive your STEM OPT application before your initial period of OPT has ended. You may not apply for STEM OPT in the 60-day grace period following the end of your OPT. Your employer must be enrolled in the E-Verify program. Inquire with your manager or human resources office to confirm if your company is enrolled. The ISS office cannot provide this information to you. If your current employer is not in the E-Verify program, then you cannot proceed with a STEM OPT application. Your employer can enroll in the E-Verify program, but that is up to their discretion. You may want to review the list of E-Verify participating employers, and if you are hired by an E-Verify company and it is prior to your post-completion OPT ending, then you may submit your STEM OPT application to the ISS office. All work that you are doing must be directly related to your STEM degree. Also, your employer must be willing to complete the Form I-983 training plan. If you have more than one employer, then they must both complete the Form I-983 and meet all other eligibility criteria. You must be working more than 20 hours a week, and you cannot have used more than 90 days of unemployment time during your initial period of OPT. The Study in the State STEM OPT Hub has resources for both you and your potential STEM OPT employer. Here, you will find detailed information on determining eligibility for STEM OPT, the reporting requirements, and the Form I-983. You will also find the list of eligible majors. These are listed as the CIP codes or SIP code. You will also be able to find frequently asked questions. Thank you for taking the time to review this information. We recommend reviewing the additional STEM OPT videos on the ISS page regarding the application process and reporting requirements while on the STEM extension. If you have additional questions about the STEM OPT process, please book an appointment with the ISS office or submit your inquiry through the ServiceNow portal found on the ISS website. Thank you.